पद्मावत इज ए 2018 इंडियन पीरियडिक रोमांटिक ड्रामा फिल्म डायरेक्टेड बाय मिस्टर संजय लीला बंसाली बेस्ड ऑन द एपिक पोयम ऑफ द सेम नेम पद्मावत विच इज रिटन बाय मलिक मोहम्मद जयसी। इट स्टार्स दीपिका पादुकोण एज रानी पद्मावती अ राजपूत क्वीन नोन फॉर हर ब्यूटी एंड द वाइफ ऑफ महारावल रतन सिंह। द रोल इज प्लेड बाय शाहिद कपूर। सुल्तान अलाउद्दीन खिलजी प्लेड बाय रणवीर सिंह hears of her beauty and attacks her kingdom to enslave her. Aditi Roy Haidari, Jim Sharp, Raja Malak and Anupriya Goenka featured in supporting roles. With a production budget of 190 crores, Padmavat is one of the most expensive Indian film ever made. Initially scheduled for release on 10th December on the year 2017, Padmavat faced numerous controversies amid violent protests. It released was indefinitely delayed. In December 2017, the Central Board of Film Certification approved the film with the new changes, and which include the addition of multiple disclaimers and a change from its original title Padmavati to Padmavat was rescheduled for release on 25th January in the year 2018 in 2D, 3D and IMAX 3D formats, making it the first Indian film to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protests by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalal-ud-Din Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with the permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only moments for him to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern-day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for it. In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Ethan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister, assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and seizes upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin frights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily, for him to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asked for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister, assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and seizes upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes, and critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife नागमती इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव. रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज, शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड. जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन. अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शनड रेड ऑन देवगिरी. ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays right to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only moment for him to be released in IMX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for it. In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received multitude positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister, assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan's storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji खालजी रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली हिज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर मेहरुन्निसा हैंड इन मैरिज देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमेन अ सीनियर कोर्टिसियन विटनेसेस द एक्ट शरीफ पाशा एंड प्रॉम्प्टली किल्ड बाय अलाउद्दीन मेहरुन्निसा इज इन्फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग द वेडिंग लीविंग हर हॉरिफाइड The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army in single modern day Sri Lanka. Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife. Nagmati eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with the permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh. And won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army in single modern day Sri Lanka. Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratchoriland. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. पद्मावती जनरेट टू मेवार वेर विथ रतन सिंह इज ब्लेस्ड बाय द रॉयल प्रिंस राघवन चेतन चेतन लेटर इंट्रोड्यूस इन टू पैलेस सीक्रेटली एंड स्पीसेस अपॉन एन इंटीमेट मोमेंट बिटवीन रतन एंड पद्मावती एंड सब्सिक्वेंटली बैनिश्ड ही देन ट्रेवल टू दिल्ली एंड इन्फॉर्म्स अलाउद्दीन ऑफ पद्मावती'स ब्यूटी अलाउद्दीन हु इज फिक्सेटेड बाय विथ हैविंग एनीथिंग दैट इज एक्सेप्शनल इनवाइट्स द राजपूत टू दिल्ली बट हिज इन्विटेशन इज रिजेक्टेड एंगेज्ड ही लेज राइट टू रतन सिंह कैपिटल चित्तौर आफ्टर सिक्स मंथ्स ऑफ अनसक्सेसफुल सीज अलाउद्दीन फाइट्स पीस ऑन अकाउंट ऑफ होली एंड इज अलाउड टू एंटर चित्तौर वेर ही मीट्स रतन सिंह ही आस्क्स टू सी पद्मावती रतन सिंह ग्रांट्स हिज रिक्वेस्ट बट ओनली मोमेंट फिल्म टू बी रिलीज इन IMAX 3D Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh. And won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with the permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan's storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. एंड क्रिटिक्स ऑल्सो डिसलाइक द पोर्ट्रेल ऑफ खिलजी एज ए स्टेरियोटिपिकल इविल मुस्लिम किंग एंड रतन सिंह एज अ राइटियस हिंदू किंग विच लेड टू प्रोटेस्ट बाई रिलीजियस कम्युनिटीज. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh. And won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and seizes upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily, for him to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. खालजी, यस खालजी रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली। ही इज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर महफूजनिसा हैंड इन मैरिज। देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमेन। अ सीनियर कोर्टिशियर विटनेसेस द एक्ट शरीफ पाशा एंड द प्रॉम्प्टली किल्ड बाय अलाउद्दीन। महफूजनिसा इज इन्फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग द वेडिंग लीविंग हर हॉरिफाइड। The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire royal pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with the permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji, yes, Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire royal pearls for his only wife नागमती इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव. रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज, शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड. जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन. अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शनड रेड ऑन देवगिरी. ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only moment for him to be released in IMX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as the lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protests by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister, assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protests by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji खालजी रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली हिज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर मेहरुन्निसा'स हैंड इन मैरिज देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमेन A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnissa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for a In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife, Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnissa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnissa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As the she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with the permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and seizes upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratchoriland. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mahrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mahrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as the lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As the she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with the permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. पद्मावती जनरेट टू मेवार वेर विथ रतन सिंह इज ब्लेस्ड बाय द रॉयल प्रिंस राघवन चेतन चेतन लेटर इंट्रोड्यूस इन टू पैलेस सीक्रेटली एंड स्पीसेस अपॉन एन इंटीमेट मोमेंट बिटवीन रतन एंड पद्मावती एंड सब्सिक्वेंटली बैनिस्ड ही देन ट्रेवल टू दिल्ली एंड इन्फॉर्म्स अलाउद्दीन ऑफ पद्मावती'स ब्यूटी अलाउद्दीन who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional invites the Rajput to Delhi but his invitation is rejected enraged he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor after 6 months of unsuccessful siege Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor where he meets Ratan Singh he asks to see Padmavati Ratan Singh grants his request but only moments him to be released in IMAX 3D Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh. And won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mahrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mahrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with the permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan's storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for it. In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Ethan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and seizes upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily, to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji, यस खालजी, रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली, ही इज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी, आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर महफूजनिसा हैंड इन मैरिज, देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमेन, अ सीनियर कोर्टिशियर विटनेसेस द एक्ट शरीफ पाशा एंड द प्रॉम्प्टली किल्ड बाय अलाउद्दीन, महफूजनिसा इज इन्फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग द वेडिंग लीविंग हर हॉरिफाइड, द वेडिंग अकर्स एंड अलाउद्दीन इज अपॉइंटेड एज लीड जनरल ऑफ जलालुद्दीन आर्मी इन सिंगल मॉडर्न डे श्रीलंका, प्रिंसेस पद्मावती एक्सीडेंटली वॉन्ट्स राजपूत रूलर ऑफ मेहर महारावल रतन सिंह वाइल हंटिंग फॉर इट इन फॉरेस्ट, एज शी ट्रीट्स हिम शी रिवील्स दैट ही इज ट्रेवल्ड टू सिन्हाला टू अक्वायर रियल पर्ल्स फॉर हिज ओनली वाइफ नागमती, इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव, रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज, शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड, जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन, अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शन रेड ऑन देवगिरी, ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन, and Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji, yes, Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for it. In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife नागमती इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव. रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज. शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड. जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन. अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शनड रेड ऑन देवगिरी. ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only moment for him to be released in IMX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Ghafur become very close and Ghafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratchoriland. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for her in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Ghafur become very close and Ghafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji खालजी रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली हिज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर मेहरुन्निसा'स हैंड इन मैरिज देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमन A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnissa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput, ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh, while hunting for a In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife, Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnissa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnissa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput, ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh, while hunting for a In forest, as she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for a in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. पद्मावती जनरेट टू मेवार वेर विथ रतन सिंह इज ब्लेस्ड बाय द रॉयल प्रिंस राघवन चेतन चेतन लेटर इंट्रोड्यूस इन टू पैलेस सीक्रेटली एंड स्पीसेस अपॉन एन इंटीमेट मोमेंट बिटवीन रतन एंड पद्मावती एंड सब्सिक्वेंटली बैनिस्ड ही देन ट्रेवल टू दिल्ली एंड इन्फॉर्म्स अलाउद्दीन ऑफ पद्मावती'स ब्यूटी अलाउद्दीन who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional invites the Rajput to Delhi but his invitation is rejected enraged he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor after 6 months of unsuccessful siege Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor where he meets Ratan Singh he asks to see Padmavati Ratan Singh grants his request but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh. And won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern-day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife. Nagmati, eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with the permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal prince Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin finds peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan's storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for her in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Ethan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister, assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travels to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin frights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily, for him to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual, cinematography, and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length, and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone, and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji, यस खालजी, रूल्स जलाल उद्दीन खालजी प्लान्स टू टेक ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली, ही इज इविल नेफ्यू अलाउद्दीन खिलजी, आस्क फॉर जलालुद्दीन डॉटर महफूजनिसा हैंड इन मैरिज, देयर वेडिंग इज ऑर्गेनाइज बट ऑन द नाइट ऑफ द इवेंट अलाउद्दीन एंगेजेस इन अडल्टरी विद अनदर वुमेन, अ सीनियर कोर्टिशियर विटनेसेस द एक्ट शरीफ पाशा एंड द प्रॉम्प्टली किल्ड बाई अलाउद्दीन, महफूजनिसा इज इन्फॉर्म्ड ऑफ दिस ड्यूरिंग द वेडिंग लीविंग हर हॉरिफाइड, द वेडिंग अकर्स एंड अलाउद्दीन इज अपॉइंटेड एज लीड जनरल ऑफ जलालुद्दीन आर्मी इन सिंगल मॉडर्न डे श्रीलंका, प्रिंसेस पद्मावती एक्सीडेंटली वॉन्ट्स राजपूत रूलर ऑफ मेहर महारावल रतन सिंह वाइल हंटिंग फॉर इट इन फॉरेस्ट, एज द शी ट्रीट्स हिम शी रिवील्स दैट ही इज ट्रेवल्ड टू सिन्हाला टू अक्वायर रियल पर्ल्स फॉर हिज ओनली वाइफ नागमती, इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव, रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज, शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड, जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन, अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शन रेड ऑन देवगिरी, ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन, and Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated by with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji, yes, Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized but on the night of the event Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for it. In forest, as the, she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife नागमती इवेंचुअली द टू बॉन्ड एंड फॉल इन लव. रतन सिंह आस्क फॉर पद्मावती हैंड इन मैरिज. शी एग्रीज एंड विद परमिशन फ्रॉम हर फादर दे आर मैरिड. जलालुद्दीन टेक्स ओवर द थ्रोन ऑफ दिल्ली एंड सेंड्स अलाउद्दीन टू रिपेल अ मंगोल इन्वेजन. अलाउद्दीन इज सक्सेसफुल इन डूइंग सो बट अंडरटेक्स एंड अनसैंक्शनड रेड ऑन देवगिरी. ही कैप्चर्स द प्रिंसिपल देयर एंड मेक हर हिज कॉन्क्यूबाइन. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only moment for him to be released in IMX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and is promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for her in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratchoriland. Execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal modes. And critics also dislike the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protest by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh and won 4 awards including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wounds Rajput ruler of Meher Maharaval Ratan Singh while hunting for her in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees and with permission from her father they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew Itan Khan warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new Sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar where with Ratan Singh is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduced into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati and as subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan Singh. He asks to see Padmavati. Ratan Singh grants his request, but only momentarily to be released in IMAX 3D. Upon release, Padmavat received mixed to positive reviews. Critics praised the visual cinematography and Singh's portrayal of evil Khilji, but criticized its storyline, execution length and adherence to regressive patriarchal mores. And critics also disliked the portrayal of Khilji as a stereotypical evil Muslim king and Ratan Singh as a righteous Hindu king, which led to protests by religious communities. Despite not being released in some state of India, it grossed over 585 crores at the box office, becoming a commercial success in the 12th highest grossing Indian film of all time. At the 64th Filmfare Award, Padmavat received a leading 18 nominations, including Best Film, Best Director for the Bansali, Best Actress Padukone and Best Actor Singh, and won 4 awards, including Best Actor. It also won 3 National Filmfare Awards, including Best Music Direction for Bansali. And the plot of the movie was really great. It's like in 13th century Afghanistan. Khalji rules Jalaluddin Khalji, plans to take over the throne of Delhi. His evil nephew Alauddin Khilji asks for Jalaluddin's daughter Mehrunnisa's hand in marriage. Their wedding is organized, but on the night of the event, Alauddin engages in adultery with another woman. A senior courtier witnesses the act, Sharif Pasha, and promptly killed by Alauddin. Mehrunnisa is informed of this during the wedding, leaving her horrified. The wedding occurs and Alauddin is appointed as lead general of Jalaluddin's army. In single modern day Sri Lanka, Princess Padmavati accidentally wants Rajput ruler of Meher Maharawal Ratan Singh while hunting for him in forest. As she treats him, she reveals that he is traveled to Sinhala to acquire real pearls for his only wife Nagmati. Eventually, the two bond and fall in love. Ratan Singh asks for Padmavati's hand in marriage. She agrees, and with permission from her father, they are married. Jalaluddin takes over the throne of Delhi and sends Alauddin to repel a Mongol invasion. Alauddin is successful in doing so, but undertakes an unsanctioned raid on Devagiri. He captures the principal there and makes her his concubine. And Jalaluddin's wife and nephew, Itan Khan, warns him against Alauddin's ambition to take over the throne. However, he journeys to Kara to meet Alauddin and gift him the slave Malik Kafur. Alauddin is Jalaluddin's minister assassinated by Malik Kafur, and Jalaluddin is killed by one of the Alauddin's generals. Alauddin then returns to Delhi and declares himself the new sultan. Over time, Alauddin and Kafur become very close, and Kafur rises to become a general in Alauddin's army. Padmavati journey to Mewar, where with Ratan Singh, is blessed by the royal priest Raghavan Chetan. Chetan later introduces into palace secretly and speeches upon an intimate moment between Ratan and Padmavati, and is subsequently banished. He then travel to Delhi and informs Alauddin of Padmavati's beauty. Alauddin, who is fixated with having anything that is exceptional, invites the Rajput to Delhi, but his invitation is rejected. Enraged, he lays siege to Ratan Singh's capital Chittor. After 6 months of unsuccessful siege, Alauddin fights peace on account of Holi and is allowed to enter Chittor, where he meets Ratan.